All right, what's going on, everybody? Today we're putting some high pressure fuel pump internals in my friend Josh's Mazda Speed 3 here today. We throw some high pressure fuel pump internals in so we can run more boost, make more power. Otherwise, you can't make more power.
The stock internals have a bit of an issue where when you're running more boost at peak torque, it'll actually drop PSI, and then you lean up and you blow up, which is commonly referred to as zoom, zoom, boom in the Mazda community. So
we don't want to do that.
No, so you buy very expensive internals, and that's what we're doing today.
Show us the pump there. So we got an Autotech pump, high-pressure fuel pump internals. We're going to take the pump off, upgrade the insides, then we're good for roughly how much at the wheels?
Probably 300 to 350 wheel on pump gas, and then you want to go E85 or water meth, you can probably get to the 400 wheel mark.
Nice, nice. Let's get into it.
Alrighty, so to get to our housing, we're going to take off this garbage. And our fuel pump housing is right here. So to access that, we're going to have to at least take off this front part of the intake just for a little more room. If you have a stock one, it's a few more steps. There's a little thing that goes into the support here, and then the whole box pops off. And we're also taking out the battery box and probably the ECU as well. All just so we can access the fuel hard lines underneath the pump. Okay, so we're gonna wanna get to this hard line here, it's gotta come off. This is a 19, and the one up top is a 17. When we get that loose, this guy here could slide down deep into there, and that sounds like a really bad time. So we're just gonna stick this zap strap around this guy here temporarily, nice and tight, just so it just doesn't slide down into the depths of the engine bay. Push down and then pull this tab into it. Oh, I see, you gotta push that tab in. Yeah. Oh, nice. Alrighty, so we had to acquire a vise from a friend, so do not do this without a vise, but normally you'd want a very deep 18 millimeter. Unfortunately, we have like a little bit of this stupid ridge inside of ours. So what we found worked best is to pull, if you stick your fingernail in the little cap, the piston will come right out. And then you give the spring a little pull, then your 18 will fit on there no problem. It is really tight, so it's good to have a friend holding the vise. And we already cracked it, and she just comes right out. Just like that. Okay, so we popped the keepers off the top because they're installed from the factory. You just pull down the top retaining ring and then they just come out. So we lubed up the shaft nice, lubed it up here with just some oil. Now we're gonna stick it in like so, and nice and gentle. It should go fairly easily on its own. And I'm gonna use a bit more oil. There we go, little twist, and she is in. Now, pop that spring back on. Now put that down on our very sanitary clean rag. And we're gonna lube up this guy as well. And the hole, you can see there's the smaller side and the bigger side. The smaller side is not going in, so bigger side in. And it just slides in nice and easy.
Nice.
In she goes. Okay, just a little hand tight. Now we need to put our keeper retainer system on. All right, so for you guys who are just wanting to see if you have high pressure fuel pump internals from a previous owner, you can see difference here is the stock one's a nice silver and the Autotech ones are a black shaft. And the main thing you can check is the top. You can see these, this use retainer and keepers, while this is just one solid piece. So that'll be your main difference. If you have that, you're almost certainly just stock internals. Okay, so installing this, you need to be extremely careful with this O-ring. If it tears or anything, you're probably gonna start pissing gas everywhere. So we put a little bit of oil on there so it goes in a little easier. And you wanna be very gentle putting it in. You should not have to give it a ton of effort. Just lightly work it in and it will get there. Just nice and even. Just be aware there's dowel pins that need to line up. And
use a bolt to bring it in.
Yeah. Okay, so getting the whole housing back on, you can see we've tightened the bolts just to the point where the O-ring is flush with the whatever's mounted to the block, whatever you want to call that, just flush, just so we can get the hard line. You see down there, it does not move very well, so we want to get it started before the pump's fully on. So we just want to make sure it's in the right spot. If you go too far,
You can see it's not quite lined up right now, but
yeah, you won't be able to get it underneath. Like, it's kind of a cup, and if it's not in and you get this all the way on, you're not going to be able to get this hard line back on. So you need to make sure you get it underneath.
Very slow, very steady.
You could mess it by hand, I bet.
No, it just has that one tight spot.
Always test. Alrighty, so as soon as you have your things installed, don't start it right away. You need to prime the key, so all the way on, but not start. If you have an access port, it's gonna help you a lot, if it'll turn on. Okay, there we go. Okay, so first time you can see, we just started the car, made sure everything was okay. So the first time you're gonna prime the key, you might see between 6 and 10 PSI on the high pressure fuel pump actual pressure, and you wanna cycle the key at least 3 times and you'll see the pressure build all the way up until 50 plus PSI. And then you want to go for your first start. most likely your car is going to be cold. So you can expect to see 16 to 1700 PSI while it's warming up. Then once it's fully warmed up, which we're not quite there, it'll go down to about 430. If it's not that, then something is wrong.
All right, everybody, that's a wrap on the high pressure fuel pump internal install on the Mazda Speed 3.
You will notice you'll get a little more of a ticky sound with the new internals. That's totally normal. You won't really notice it in the car. It is a bit of a tough job, so if you're not confident, it's always a good idea if you have local car clubs, maybe reach out to someone who's done it before, or even just take it to a shop. You don't want to ruin an expensive part if you're not very confident in your abilities.
As always, thanks for watching. Smash the like button and subscribe down below for more Mazda Speed 3 content, and thanks for watching.
Sick. Next video. Big turbo water meth E85.
Full bolt on, shooting for 450 wheel.